Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. So this is a collective reading, pick a card. So it is who around you is fake, two-faced and not to be trusted, basically. So I thought that might be a juicy one to look into. So it could be a partner, it could be a friend, it could be a relative, it goes on and on and on. But anyway, so card one, we have the way out, something good is on its way, birthing a new life. So that's card one. Beautiful cards, these. And then we have card two, which is vision, questing, karmic forgiveness, let go and let God. And then we have the critical moment, follow your intuition. So I'll see you at your cards, guys. Hey, pile one. So if you chose the way out, something good is on the way. Oh, excuse me. Sorry, I just drank some Coke. So don't forget, guys, take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't force anything. And if it's not your pile, choose another one. So with this card here, we've got something that's been restricting you. But obviously, because we're looking into who around you is fake. So from this card, from what I'm getting here, guys, is that someone in your life actually restricts your... not so much your movements, you know. Say if you come up with an idea, pile one, they'll restrict it in a way of by putting you off, if you know what I mean. See, look, we've got the evil eye here. That, I mean, seeing as that is the evil eye up there. So this person, it's like they've got nothing good to say about you or feel about you or think about you, because that's what the evil eye is all about, is sending out negative energy and bad thoughts to someone, basically. So anyway, so something or someone, well, someone has been restricting you and holding you back on things, okay? And your spirit guides are actually saying that they're there to support you. They're trying to give you the push to stop this, you know, from happening. And because it seems to be happening quite a bit with you guys, okay? The white horse here, spirit is saying you're about to release it, you're about to let it go. So let's see who this energy here is that's come through. Right, let's get these cards first before I get the tarot cards, get a bit more information on the person for you guys that's being you know, fake. So spirit, angels, ancestors, tell me for pile one, please, who is fake, who's two-faced? So you're dealing with someone of the opposite sex. Contrasted energies, alternative viewpoints, secret admirer getting preference. But that's not what I'm really going on by these cards. I'm going on more of these here. So it's someone that is the opposite sex to you. So who is fake around my pile ones? Who's not to be trusted? Who is fake around my pile ones? Who's not to be trusted, please? Oh, my God. Okay. Seriously? Right, we'll just take those then, isn't it? So on the back of the deck, we have dark skin. She could be dealing with someone that's got dark skin. Then you've got someone that's middle-aged, someone that's young. So don't forget, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. You don't have to take all of it here, because, like, don't forget, so many people watch these videos. So middle-aged, young, they're curvy. Could be a Taurus. And could be a Pisces as well that you're dealing with here, okay? But we are definitely dealing with an opposite sexier part one. So let's have a look. So spirit. Hang on, give me a sec, guys. Sorry, guys, I had to pause it there for a sec. Right, so let's get back to that. Who around you is fake? So spirit, tell me who is around my pile ones is fake and two-faced and not to be trusted. Okay, we have the seven of pentacles, six of pentacles, seven of, I think that is cups, and the six of cups as well. Yeah, it's cups. Um Okay. So this could be someone that you had a relationship in the past with, someone, you know, of the opposite sex, like that's what the card said over there. So it could have been someone that you actually was in a relationship with, you know, or it could have been that you just had this strong emotional connection to this person because they're actually someone from your past, like someone that you could have grown up with. So, you know, there was a lot of emotions involved here. But see, this person, what I'm getting here, guys, is someone that you'd spend quite a bit of time with. You know, you both plot things, you know, you get up to no good with each other is what I'm getting here. So it could be that, you know, this is a friend. And you, I feel like you lot grew up together here as well. Bear with me, guys, a minute. Yeah, this is someone that you've known for a long time, pile one, okay? This is someone that you would, like I said, get up to no good with them, you know, that you get up to mischief is what I'm picking up on here. This was an equal give and take relationship as well, or friendship. I'm picking up more friendship here. This was something that you both gave to one another, you know, like emotionally supported one another, financially would help each other out every now and again when you could. Why is the Seven of Cups there though? This is what's confusing me here. I don't know, a pie one, whether this person's offered you some kind of maybe wanting to take it to the next step, maybe wanting to take the relationship to the next level, basically, you know, wanting more. But the Seven of Cups is really bugging me because Seven of Cups is having other options, you know, keeping your options open, basically, having multiple choices. And I feel like for you, pile one, you hold back from this person from taking it to that level because they have, I'm picking up a bit of a player vibes here, guys, is what I'm picking up, okay? That's why you don't really trust them. You've got deep feelings for this person. You deeply care about them. You know, there's even love here. You've had a lot of good times with this person, but I feel like you don't trust them enough. You know, and if your intuition has already been telling you this, you know, maybe this is what's confused you, is like, do I not? If your intuition's already telling you that you can't trust this person, then listen to that intuition, basically. So let me look at the Seven of Cups. Tell me about the Seven of Cups, please, Spirit. So we have Death. That is Temperance and the Devil. It's basically what I said. Where I said they've got other options, okay? And something's screaming at you that you can't trust this person when it comes to your heart, basically. Maybe you did have a little something with them in the past, you know, when you were younger or back in the day, but then it turned into friendship is what I'm picking up on, you know. So you've stayed in touch with one another, but you do not trust them to take this to the next level. Even though they're trying to convince you that it's like, you know, an equal give and take thing and whatever, you still do not trust this person. Now, you obviously your intuition is screaming, and it's right at the end of the day, because we've got Death here, we've got Temperance, and then we've got the Devil here. Now, with Death, it's endings and new beginnings. So, I feel like you've had to put a stop to this person that I don't know. quite get in here? Something happened between you two that you you put a stop to it, you ended it. And I feel like that is going to the next level, guys, okay? You totally was like, no, I'm not doing that, because you know that if you were to get with this person here, this energy here, you know that they would end up, they will unbalance you, basically, because the temperance is all about inner peace and harmony. It's all about being in alignment. It's all about feeling balanced, you know? Look at the way she's holding those bowls there. And you know that if you were to go down that road with them, because they have got this player vibe, you know, or player energy about them, you know that that's not the case. You'll end up in the devil energy here. You know they're toxic. You know that they've got, you know, it could be sex addictions, you know, like I said, multiple choices here. You know that they're not good for you. You know, the devil is all about being greedy. It's all about controlling. It's, you know, it's all about addictions and... I feel like, you know what, part one, I feel like you guys are actually pretty clever people. It's like you're not letting this person pull the walls all over your eyes. You see right through them is what I'm seeing. You know, look at the red eyes here, even though this is the devil card. I do believe like this is you. You know, I see you for who you are is what I'm getting here. And a part of you, you know, a big part of you would really like to trust this person. You really would, but... You know, maybe for some of you par ones, you really do want to, you know, have more with this person. But because you know them for who they are, you don't trust them full stop. We have the Queen of Pentacles. You know, they see you, you see them as well. Both of you see each other as someone very, very valuable in their life. Like, basically, you treasure each other. You know, which is really nice. But you don't want to cross that boundary. Tell me a bit more about this death here. Justice. Yeah, look. You've... I feel like you've already put a stop to this. Justice is all about making a decision, and a right decision that's for, you know, that's good for you at the end of the day, pile one, not for the other person. And you do judge this person for what they do and how they act, you know, even though you do still really care for them and love them, but you don't want to be any part of this. Yeah, look, Three of cups here. This is a friendship group. This is definitely a friend here that I'm picking up on, that you've had a long-term friendship with them. You know, you go out, you have a lot of fun, you get up to no good, like I said. But there's always other parties involved. There's never just one girl or one boy. It's like a line of one-night stands is what I'm picking up on, which is, who wants to freaking get involved with that, innit? So, yeah, I feel like... You've doubted yourself, maybe you've made the wrong decision, but obviously with this reading, Spirit is saying, no, you haven't. And I'm picking up that you are clever when it comes to seeing through people's shit, and especially this person's shit. So what advice would you give to my power ones, please, Spirit? What advice would you give to my power ones? In regards to this situation here, with this energy here. Yeah, look. Spirit is saying, close the chapter. Just close the door on it. Don't reopen it. Don't. That's what Spirit's advice is to you. The world is all about endings. You know, things being closed, things finishing. Are you plan planning on walking away at part one, like for good, and not even continuing with the friendship is what I'm picking up as well. Back at the deck, we've got the Five of Swords, which is defeat. It's like nobody's going to win in this situation here. Tell me about the Devil. What's going on? Has this person got a bit toxic towards you because they can't take no for an answer? Tell me about the Devil. Oh, frick. Did any more come out? No. No, I don't feel like, I just feel like you're putting an end to, I feel like this person's pressuring you. This is like kind of cringe, to be honest. We've got Libra energy here. We've got Sagittarius as well. We've got Scorpio energy as well. And we've got Capricorn energy as well here, so be any of those star signs. I feel like you're putting a stop to it now. I feel like you're just emotionally drained from it all, like the constant badgering about taking it to the next level. Maybe they just keep coming on to you and you're just like getting quite uncomfortable and fed up with it now. So you are putting an end to this. I don't feel like you're actually ending the friendship. I just feel like you're just gonna just really lose the plot one day is what I'm picking up on. What more do you have, Spirit? What advice do you have? Or it could be Spirit is saying, because this person emotionally drains you, stop it from going any further. You can see it that way as well with the World. Strength, look, you have the strength to do it, is what Spirit says. You totally have the strength to do this. You've got the Ace of Wands and the Page of Wands. I love these cards. So colourful. Spirit's advice to you is you've got a passionate new beginning, you know, a passionate new start. You're feeling passionate about something. And if you are feeling passionate about something, go for it as well. But I also see this card, guys, as a little bit of a warning here as well. And from Spirit is that the person you are dealing with thinks with their wand, okay? And it don't matter whether it's female as well, same sort of thing. But if you look at it, it looks like, you know, and this person could even have contracted some sort of STDs as well, you know, because look at the things that are sprouting out of it as well. So, you know your worth. You know whoever this is. This is very weird. I just said STD. STD, STI, STD, whatever. And she's holding a wand as well. Sorry, if you can hear my belly growling, I haven't eaten. I'm just going to do a reading from my belly growling. Just ignore it. She's holding the wand as well. So Spirit is a warning here as well for you guys. Okay. Is that if you do sleep with this person, you could end up catching something as well. It could be passed on to you. So that's a bit of a warning for you guys. Okay. For some of you, if you already have slept with them and you feel like you made a mistake and maybe you need to get yourself checked, you know, but I'm not a doctor. So yeah. You're really passionate about something, and you're passionate about not doing this with this energy here. You know, I feel like you're going to show them how passionate you are about it. You know, you're coming up with a plan. You want to do it in a nice way, because part ones, you lot are not horrible people, you know, but you're going to be quite swift with this news as well. You're going to be maybe telling them over a text or over the phone, but you are very passionate about not going anywhere near this person. And I feel like you are going to tell them about themselves, because there's fire sign here. Leo, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius here as well. You know what they're like? They're really fiery. So I'm going to leave it there, pile one. And you take care. Bye. Hey, pile two. So if you chose this card, vision, questing, karmic, forgiveness, let go and let God. what this card is saying is that you're dealing with someone that is fake. It's all about illusions. It could be that, you know, you're dealing with someone that shows a side of themselves that's not the real them, or even people in your life as well. Now, these people bring a lot of drama into your life as well. And the thing is as well here, you, with this card, it seems like you've got a, you're dealing with a karmic or karmics. So we see who comes out in the cards. The thing is as well, you've got like this karmic debt that needs to be paid off. So it's like these karmics follow you through. And spirit says with this card that you can actually get rid of these karmics, you know, deal with your karma that you're bringing into your next life by, you know, being loving, being kind, you know, and offering forgiveness to these people, even though I know it's really freaking hard to do that when people have hurt you. But if you could just do that, you let go of that karma and these people don't follow you into the next life. So that's what this card is saying here. So let's get a bit more information on the energy here. So spirit, tell me more about my pile twos. Who around them is fake? Two-faced. This person is moody, scattered energies, unfinished goals and overspending. So so this person, like I said about illusions at the beginning with this card, like they show you one side of themselves. Maybe they fake it that they've got money, you know, that they're the, you know, I'm it and I've got this and I've got that. I feel like a show off energy here, but their moods are like up and down, up and down, up and down. So that's who you're dealing with here. Let's see if there's any more. So tell me, spirit, for Palmer Pile twos, who around them is fake, two-faced and not to be trusted? Okay, this could be someone that you're having a love affair with. Okay. Let me just get a couple of more cards a minute. Hang on, let me just get a few more. Tell me a bit more, please, Spirit for Pile 2. They're a Scorpio. If you're dealing with a Scorpio here. So what I'm picking up with these three cards here, where it's saying a love affair as well. Someone with a big ego on the back of the deck as well. Someone that can be quite materialistic. And that's exactly where I was going to go with this here when I said at the beginning that this energy here shows you a side of them that's not true, okay? Shows you a side of them that, yeah, you're on shot. Shows you that they've got money when really they don't have money. And maybe you've been having a bit of doubts here that, you know, maybe something's not quite right here. Maybe your intuition is telling you this, my pile twos. But the person you shouldn't be trusting is whoever you're in a love affair with at the moment. You know, they're showing you a fake side to them that's not real. Okay? So let's get a bit more here from pile twos. So tell us more about this fake person, this fake energy here, two-faced energy from my pile twos. Spirit, please. Tell me more about this energy here. This, tell me more about this moody person. Stubborn energy here. Tell me more, please, spirit. Ooh, it doesn't want to give up. Doesn't want to give it up. Tell me more, please, spirit. Oh, my God, that's too many. No. Tell me more. I saw the chariot there when I picked those cards up. So this person could have a flashy car, but really doesn't really have the funds to actually... I'm picking up BMW as well. I don't know why that just flashed in my head. They drive a flashy car, but they can't actually afford the car. It's like they're trying... Oh, they just, I'm taking them. It's like this got something to say here. Okay, on the back of the deck, the energy is the Four of Wands. You know, this could be your twin flame. It could be, you may feel like it's your twin flame, but I'm picking up it could be a false twin flame here, guys, okay? This could be someone that you could have either previously got engaged to as well. You know, it could be that you've moved in with them and all, or you're preparing, you know, you're, this is coming. So it could be that you're planning on moving in with them or getting engaged, getting married. You know, some of you could actually be getting married, but there's this fakeness around this person that's not to be trusted. Now we have the Emperor, we have the Eight of Wands, we have the Nine of Wands, and the Ten of Wands. Oh dear. Okay, with the Emperor here, got it out. Aries energy here as well, guys. Okay, now with the Emperor, they like to control the situation. Okay, they like things done a certain way, they like to plan things. And with this energy that I'm picking up with, it's like, you know, they're controlling the situation. I feel like they're even controlling the way you think. You know, I feel like there's gaslighting going on here with you guys, Pearl, too. That, you know, when you've questioned them, they've made you act like you're crazy, and then you doubt yourself. Okay, this is, you know, in that main card up there, the illusions. You're surrounded by illusions here. You're surrounded with a karmic. This is why I'm saying I feel like this is a false twin flame. We've got the Emperor here, which is the divine masculine here, but I feel like he's not the genuine, he's not the real deal. You are being shown the an illusion when it comes to the Emperor. You know, the Emperor seen in the truth, not the truthful, in the weak form of the Emperor is what you're actually dating here or seeing, is someone that is very weak-minded, you know. And that's who you're dealing with. So we have the Eight of Wands, which is something that's very swift. They're going to be sending you, they're going to be bringing some kind of news to you. Like they're going to drop a bomb on you. Wait a minute, guys. Let me leave those two there a minute. What is this news, Spirit? What is the eight? Tell me about the Eight of Wands from Pile Twos. Tell me about the Eight of Wands. God, seriously, Spirit, really? Don't think so. Tell me about the Eight of Wands. Two of Cups, Three of Cups, Strength. And then the Three of Swords. What's going on here? Something's coming towards you guys. Some kind of news or message is coming towards you. Why is the Three of Swords here? This is heartbreak and a breakup of a relationship. It also can be a third party. Now we've got the Three of Cups there as well, which is a third party, like as well, or celebrations, weddings, blah blah blah. But I don't feel like it is a right. Okay, I see what's going on here now. Thank you, Spirit. That confused me there for a minute. This energy is a bit weird. It's like they don't really want to let on of what's really like going on. I think they're going to come and tell you guys that there is that maybe like the engagement might be cancelled or moving in together. They're going to tell you that they're having problems, and they're going to act like all wounded and, you know, like I'm you know, really depressed about this. And didn't we get that at the beginning? Overspending. Scattered energies. Yeah, I feel like they're going to come to you and tell you something that's going to upset you. Maybe the truth will come out that they can't afford to either move in with you, or, you know, I don't know, if you're going to get married, or, you know, there was going to be an engagement or anything. You know, it's around that there. And this is actually going to cause you quite a lot of stress. I feel like they're going to just dump their whole, like, all the lies. I'm trying to get it out here. All the lies that they've been telling you, you know, where they've got money but they don't have money, and now it's become your burden. They're going to literally dump all their crap on you, pile two, you know. And it could be that you're going to have to start paying debts and, you know, paying off things, and which is really, really selfish, to be honest. You know, you love this person, but this is going to break your heart. Where, you know, whatever it is, when you find out the truth about what they're really like, it is actually going to break your heart, and you may end up finishing it with them because of this, because of the lies, because you're now seeing who this person is around you. Now, you deeply love this person. You actually feel like this is your soulmate, but then, like I said, you feel like it's your soulmate. You feel like it's your twin flame, but this is a false. This is all false. This is not the true twin flame or soulmate. Now, I do feel like there is a celebration coming up. I feel like there is a wedding or an engagement. You know, there's a celebration coming up, and your heart's going to be broken over the news that they're going to give you in regards to this. But Spirit is saying you are a strong person here. You are, you know, strong-minded. You can cope with this. You can deal with this. Tell me about the Nine of Wands and the Ten of Wands, please, Spirit. Tell me about the Nine of Wands and the Ten of Wands. Tell me about the Nine of Wands and the Ten of Wands. Oh wow, okay. I don't know whether this energy here, guys, pile two, is really freaking stubborn, but honestly, it's like they're full of secrets. Four of Pentacles, the Hermit, the Princess of Wands, and the Eight of Cups. Okay, I'm going to be honest here, guys, all right? And I am always honest, but this is a bit of a sensitive thing that I'm seeing in the cards, and it's not nice. But, you know, if I'm seeing it, I'm going to say it. And if it's upsetting, please don't stay and watch it. Just switch it off. But I feel like the burden that they're going to put on you when they come to bring you a message or to communicate with you is that, I don't even feel like that. My God, what an arse. I feel like you're actually going to get told via text message here the chicken shit way out of the situation. This energy here is going to be walking away from you. They're going to be leaving you, I feel like, in a lot of debt. You're really going to have your eyes opened here, pile two, when it comes to this situation here of the amount of mess that this person's actually caused you. That's why I feel like the heartbreak was on the back of the deck earlier. They're going to go into hiding. You're not even going to know where they are. They're going to, like, they're literally going to run away like a coward and hide from this situation and leave you to pick up all the pieces, pile two. And I'm really sorry about that. Okay? They've come up with a plan. they're planning this. This is, you know, hopefully if it hasn't happened yet, you know, maybe like seeing this, you can maybe try and figure out what's going on before they do it. So they've come up with a plan, and they're going to be, you know, it's either, like I said, a message over text message or a phone call, but I feel like it's more of a text message telling you that they're leaving or that they've left. Tell me about the Two of Cups and the Three of Cups. Tell me about the Two of Cups and the Three of Cups. King of Swords and the Prince of Swords. Do you know what, guys? You're the King of Swords. You're actually a king. This person is a prince, that which is a page, okay? We're looking at air sign here as well, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius here, quite strong. Now, what's so nice about seeing these two cards side by side, like I said, you're dealing with someone that is the Page of Swords. Someone that is planning something at the moment. They may be trying to gather information, you know, maybe trying to get away with something. But I've already said that this person's going to do a runner, but, you know, they're going to do it in such a cowardly way, okay? But it also could be you, that you've started to now spy on this person, trying to find out the truth about what's going on, okay? There's going to be arguments between you both if you're still with this person. And it's going to bring a lot of gossip surrounding your relationship as well, if this has already happened with them buggering off. A lot of people are going to be getting involved. So yeah, there's going to be a lot of gossip surrounding this situation here. It's like, I feel like you guys are going to feel embarrassed, but I really wouldn't feel embarrassed, because it's not you didn't do anything. It's actually them, that they should be ashamed of themselves. But this is why I like this with the King of Swords. This is you guys here. You know, the King of Swords is someone that is very strong. You're very intelligent people, and you're very logical as well. You know, you're going to detach yourself from the emotional side of things. I feel like you're going to stand your ground. You're going to deal with it in a logical way, not with your heart, basically. You know, because you guys have morals, and the King of Swords is someone that can see through crap from a mile away, basically, you know. And I do feel like your intuition has been screaming at you for a while that something was not right here. Look at this. This person is greedy. They want it all, but they don't have it. You're someone that has a really good job. You know, you're financially secure. So just watch your funds around this person, okay, guys, as well. If they've got access to any of your funds, lock that down. Lock that down is what I'm picking up here as well. You know, you're in a position of authority as well. But the High Priestess, she's a secret keeper. She is. There's a lot of secrets, a lot of illusions. But your intuition has been screaming at you that, you know, there's more to this than meets the eye. So let's get some advice for you guys from Spirit. What advice do you give my pile twos? Please, Spirit. What advice do you give my pile twos? Ten of Cups, Princess of Cups. Right, Spirit is saying the advice to you is, there is marriage in your future here. There is a higher up commitment here. You know, you've got, yeah, you've got a serious commitment here. Spirit is saying marriage. You've got the Six of Wands, which is victory. So, you know, you're going to feel victorious. Look at this, the Lovers. Spirit is saying there's someone else. There's a better choice out there for you, a better option, a better person for you, you know, for you. So, but we've got the Ten of Cups here, which is happily ever after, Spirit is saying. You know, all your dreams will come true. You will have that family. You will have that connection with someone. You will have, you know, moving in together, the marriage and everything. This is overall a beautiful card here. And the Princess of Cups, which is the Page of Cups. This is someone, I feel like you've got an admirer here. Someone that admires you from afar, that's had a thing for you for a while. So there is somebody else here in your future. And this is what Spirit's saying. That's the person you're not to trust up there, but you've got good stuff coming for you in the future. Once you get over this and you move forward, there's someone better out there for you guys. So I'm going to leave it there, pile two. You take care and I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, pile three. So if you chose the critical moment card, this is your reading. So it says the critical moment, follow your intuition. So Spirit is saying you need to follow your intuition in regards to a situation or someone. So basically what this card is saying is that you are, my pal friends, you are the type of people that you get noticed for your beauty and your grace. You know, you've got this way about you. You know, you're very attractive. You're very beautiful. You've got like the eye here, which is a lot of people send out the evil eye, because I'm picking up jealousy with this card, okay? And Spirit is saying, please listen to your intuition when it comes to this card. So let's get some of these cards first. So tell us more from my pile three. Who around them is fake and two-faced? You could be dealing with a Capricorn. This is a friend. So like I said, it could be that, you know, you go out and you get all the attention and the friend is very jealous, you know, because you guys are very beautiful. Did that turn over? They're someone that's local. This is someone that is in the same area, city or country as you. So they're close to you. Let's get a couple more. Pile three. So around them is fake and two-faced. Oh, I'll take them. Whoever this is likes to stalk you. So it could be that. Look at the evil eye again. Guys, I don't know whether, you know, this is my religion because I'm Turkish, you know, we're all about the evil eye, us Turks, anyway. So, I don't know whether you wear evil eyes or you've got any evil eyes. I don't even know if you can see my big evil eye in my reading here. That's all the way from Cyprus, that is. But you really maybe need to get yourself something to wear around you, because, like I said, because you guys are actually very attractive people, it's just like, I'm picking up severe jealousy. Seriously, guys, severe jealousy. I just think you've just got this thing about you that you turn heads in a room. You know, you don't even need to say anything, and it's like, wow, you know. Let's see if the King or the Queen of Wands comes out, because they're the attractive couple in the deck, or the people in the deck. And this one is egotistical, depressed, and materialistic as well. So this person has got big ego, is full of themselves, very materialistic. So it could be a friend that you go out drinking with after work. You know, it could be someone that you work with, that you go out and then you have good times because there's a wine glass there. Or you spend evenings together telling each other, you know, girly things or manly things, if you want to put it that way. So yeah, you've got different backgrounds. Someone who is not in your circle or comes from another country, area, culture, background, and does a different job. So, you know, this is a friend that doesn't work with you, from what this card is saying, for some of you, so take what resonates. Or it could be someone that is from a different background, a different culture, has got a different job to you, you know. Lower vibrations, dealing with fear, shame, anger, jealousy, negative criticism. So you're basically dealing with someone that is working at a low vibration to you guys, pile three. Now, this is someone that will shame you as well into feeling like you shouldn't be getting the attention. I had a friend like that years ago. Oh my God. I'm going off a bit topic here, but we went out one night and it was back in the hot pants days, you know, the 90s, good old days. And I come out of the bedroom and she goes, "You are not wearing that." And I was like, "Why?" And believe it or not, she actually said, "You're not getting more attention than I am." But did I change? Fuck, did I? No, I didn't. Anyway, that's the kind of jealousy you guys are actually dealing with. They'll have digs at you, you know, to make you feel insecure about yourself. Like, oh God, should I be wearing this? Oh God, should I have my hair like this? Oh God, should I be saying that? You know, this is someone that literally criticizes you all the time. Impulse, argumentative, critical, conceited, destructive. Jesus, who's this person in your lives, pal? Freaking heck. I feel like you guys are so nice, though, that you don't like to hurt people as well. But they can be really, like, critical again, you know. They'll argue with you about over something really stupid. They're in your circle. As I said, friend there, and they've got fair skin, okay, for some of you. So let's get a bit more. This one's a bit juicy. Every pile has been different, which is really interesting. I like that. So, who around my pub? No, tell me more about this friend here. This friend for my pile three. Why are they fake? Spirit. Tell me more about this. Thank you. The Fool. Tell me a bit more. So what I'm getting with the Fool here, I feel like you two, it could be that you both may have gone through similar situations and you both had to start again, and that may be why you, that drew you both to each other. So, you know, that's how you bonded as friends. Empress. This is someone that could have children, is someone that can be a mum. But no, what I'm seeing here is you're the divine feminine, and this makes a lot of sense. In regards to you guys with the beauty, the Empress is beautiful inside and out. You know, she's got grace, she's got style. You're kind to people. You don't, you know, you're never horrible to people. You don't like to hurt people. But there is a point with the Empress, which is you guys, hopefully, that once you push the Empress too far, she will strike back, you know. And then seeing for the whoever this friend is here, I'm going to keep saying friend because the friend card came out, it's much easier. This is someone that abuses the friendship and can be quite abusive towards you. King of Pentacles, you're financially secure, you know. It could be that you own your own business, you know. You're very successful, you're very humble, you're very generous as well with people that you love. You're financially independent. And this is where I feel like, because you've got the beauty, the grace, the money, you know, you've got it all. There's just this really strong, strong jealousy around you guys. Tell us a bit more, please. Spirit. Oh my God. Oh, balls. I'll just take it. So, what do we have? So we have the Six of Wands. Oh no. Nope, we have the Seven of Wands. I think that is. That's the Six of Wands. Sorry, guys. These are new cards. I'm just looking at the ones. Is that Swords? No, it's Wands. So, yeah, you have the Seven of Wands. You have the Six of Wands. Then you have the Five of Wands. A lot of Wands here, guys. A lot of energy here. Then you have Six of Swords and the Seven of Cups. And then you have the Five of Swords. Jeez, guys, you have, oh my goodness, you have so many swords. You know, this is all about truth. This is all about, you know, honesty. It's all about, you know, overthinking, or, you know, and I feel like this is why, like, your intuition is screaming at you. Maybe because, like, you guys are not listening to it. So, more about this person here. This person, when they get bit in their bonnet, or whenever they're the way they are with you, they will stand their ground. There is no you talking to them or talking them down. There's, you know, it's like, no, I'm right, you're wrong. And it's like, you just take this palfrey. Why? Then you have the Six of Wands. You know, this person feels like they've got this hold over you. Like, they feel so empowered that they can treat you like this. It's like a drug, like an addiction to them, that they can, it's like pick up bullying, guys. And they feel so victorious over this, like, you know, it's I feel like they get their little pom-poms out in their heads, and they, you know, they give themselves a little dance that they've put you down, and they've said something nasty, they've made you feel insecure about yourself. Horrible energy, honestly. Seven of Cups. Now, it's all about choices. This is all about making the right decision, you know. And I feel like you don't know what to do. This is why you're not listening to your intuition. You know, one minute you're wanting to do one thing with this person, next minute you want to do another thing with them. And I feel like you do want to get out of this, but you're just not sure in what direction to take this. Sometimes it's just best to just walk away and don't say anything. My motto. And then you've got the Five of Wands here, guys. The Five of Wands speaks about conflict, arguments, you know, bickering, backstabbing. And this is what this person brings into your life. They don't bring you no harmony. They don't bring you no peace. They bring you conflict all the time. Spirit is saying that, you know, you need to start moving into calmer waters here. You need to get out of this, because on the back of the deck here, like I said, with the Five of Swords, you know, you just got to admit defeat. There is no change in this person. There's no this person becoming a better person. And you have to admit this to yourself, and you have to realize this yourself. So what does my palfreys need to know about the situation, Spirit, please? What does my palfreys need to know about this situation? Spirit. Oh, finally. Bloody hell. Come out there now. Two of Cups. Tell me about the Two of Cups. Tell me about the Two of Cups. Oh. Tell me about the Two of Cups, please. Oh, fucking heck. Oh, okay. Alright then, whatever, that fell out. Right, Spirit is saying, guys, you've got a passionate new beginning. If you can move yourself away from this energy here that's bringing you down, they've most probably ruined your... You know, when you start seeing someone, I feel like they've... Maybe you're not even aware of this, palfrey, that they may have actually... ruined your connections or your relationships with partners here. You know, when you just start seeing someone and they've dug the knife in, it could be that because of the Seven of Cups being there, that they've told them that you have multiple options, you know, you have other partners, and made you out to be a bit of a player here, when that's not the case. And that's caused a lot of arguments between you and your other partners as well, like your other relationships. And I do feel like they have sabotaged your connections, you know, even friendships as well. And Spirit is saying that you need to get away from this energy here, because you're, you know, there is calmer waters ahead here. There's smooth sailing ahead here. There's peace on the way to you if you could just leave this behind. And what they're saying is, you've got the Two of Cups here, better connections with people. you know, meaningful connections with people. It could be soulmates, you know, don't necessarily mean that, you know, that it's a love soulmate, but, you know, it could be people that you know, you're solely connected to. But also this can be seen as a connection with someone, you know, like true love, you know, mutual love, both of you being in love, basically, you know, and you've got a passionate new start, you know, a passionate second chance as well. And Spirit is saying that if you were to walk away from this friend here, that you're going to find passion in life again, in things that you like doing, because they've held you back, they've put you down when it, in regards to that. So yeah, you're going to start finding passion in life again for you, you know. You're going to start restoring balance and harmony in your life here. You're going to start feeling in alignment with yourself again, because this person does put you out of alignment, you know. They make you feel very unbalanced. Any more advice on a pile of phrase here, please, Spirit? Any more? Okay. I would have taken those two. They got stuck there. Nine of Pentacles, and wow, look at this, guys. You know, the table's about to turn. You know, the wheel is turning in your favor. You've got good karma coming to you. You've got good fortune coming to you. You are the Queen of Pentacles. I've already said that King of Pentacles came out. You are valuable. You know, people see that and will see that about you. It's just that you've got to see it about you, you know. But you've got, you know, you're single at the moment, you're, you know, you're loving life, you're living your best life, you're doing very well for yourself as well. A lot of pentacles here, and they're all the good pentacles, which is lovely. The only thing that's missing is that love, which is that Two of Cups here, this Two of Cups connection, you know, and it's available for you. You've got working hard here, you know, you do work hard on your career, and, you know, if you've got a business, you are working really hard. But sometimes Spirit is saying that you may need to work hard on yourself as well, you know, your self-esteem, or just work on you. Let me get a little bit more advice for you guys. I don't like this energy here. It's freaking horrible. Any more advice? Any more advice in regards to this friend for pile three? Two of Pentacles. Okay. Yeah, look. Thanks, Spirit. Love when they do that. Spirit is saying the advice when it comes to this friend, you're always going to be unbalanced in regards to this friend here. You're always going to try, you're always going to be, you are always going to be trying to balance the scales, basically, you know, balance the situation, try and please this person, you know, to keep them on an even keel, you know, but Spirit is saying it's never going to be balanced, it's always going to be off balance, you know, the friendship is not, it's not equal, it's one-sided. You know, and you're putting all your efforts into it. You've worked hard to try and make this friendship work. But Spirit is saying that it's about to close. It's about to end. It's coming to an end. That's what the world is. And Spirit's saying, you know, hopefully that's what you guys are going to do. That you're going to close the chapter on this. So I'm going to leave that here, guys. You take care and I'll see you soon. Bye.